corn.
Come out, Judah.
Oh, you mix this up yourself. Right.
Come out. Come on.
This is the lesson I want them just lay eggs. Yeah. I wouldn't feed them nothing else but this.
Yeah.
You see, and what happens is they'll drop me some eggs. More. But I don't want to
stress
them.
Sorry.
Plus, I won't build a pig up. Yeah. And so they're going to have more privacy than they lay eggs. So for now, all this feed doing is really brightening their feather, giving them more color. You know?
Okay, all right.
So yeah, just giving them more color, putting some weight on them, you know. So like I said, they were more on the smaller side, losing feather and whatnot. But I mean, as you can clearly see, beautiful, right?
Yeah.
Also, usual item where you could raise these for meat birds.
Yeah.
You see? So with all this Judah in the feed.
Mm-hmm.
with all of this corn, you know, because corn and wheat have oil.
Yeah.
With all of that, what's happening is they're developing a lot of fat.
Yeah, that's why. A coat look early.
Right. If you peel the egg, like I said, it's more on the smaller side. We had some whites. By this time, the whites would have been bigger. The chest would have been out here.
Yeah.
Because of the feed, because of the kind of feed. Mm-hmm. So you try to keep them more on a healthier feed.
Yeah.
And then they get a good plain of grass.
Yeah.
And every now and again, they change their grass.
Yeah.
And fresh water. So try not to stress them out too. That's another thing. But these are still young. They actually, as you notice, the feather, back end, still young. Unlike the leghorn. Where is she? The leghorn. Right. Let me see if I can catch the leghorn.
Judah, you're going back again?
The leghorn is the hardest one to catch. Close the chicken door.
Come out.
I can close the door on you, boy.
So, the leghorn. Now, if you feel her, even though she's scrawnier.
She ain't bigger.
But she's heavier.
Heavier.
She's heavier than them.
Okay.
I had her longer.
But yeah, she ain't as fat either.
Right. So she's fit, actually. Yeah. And when she came, she had a lot of hair, some hair missing. She was still young. And then she got picked on.
Go to there.
She got picked on a bit, but she, I must say, her feather and everything just.
So what you need now is, you need to breed them.
Yep. That's what I need. That's a rooster
to breed them.
Well, with that said, we can go straight into, this is my father. Hi, YouTube family. Blessed Sunday in the Most High. Hope everybody's having a great day. Today, I know we started off the video without me introducing. My wife decided to just jump in the recording. But this is my father, Cleophas Johnson, also known as a Bushman.
Hi.
Right? He does excellent tea. He knows a lot about the natural green herbs and wild plants. So I'm going to turn it over to him and have him explain while I step out of the way.
Right.
Okay. I am not a doctor who seeks cures.
Right.
I am a humanitarian. I seek the prevention.
Right.
Prevention is better than the cure.
That's true.
If your child has a problem with maintaining is urine control, especially at nighttime when wets the bed. This here is known as love wine.
Okay.
You can take this love wine, tie the child's waist with it. Let him sleep in the love wine belt. Along with that, you make sure that child drink some strong bark tea that develops the immune system and the mental strength against wetting the bed.
Okay.
It's medical.
What?
Go ahead. Mm-hmm.
Shepherd needle and water grass. It cools the blood system.
Okay.
The doctors will not like to hear me tell you this because they will even try to maybe sue me to sell it for falsification information. But what I'm telling you about this, I have experience. I didn't learn it in a book or hear it, but I have experience. Somewhere along the line, someone from one of the Indies islands, somewhere, not the Bahamas, but somewhere in the West Indies, somebody, there wasn't a doctor, but one old lady said, boy, go drink some water grass and shepherd needle. It will cool your blood system and all that hyper and high temper and all that you have, you'll be better off tomorrow. So I said, where's the water grass? She said, go where your parents them is wash, and where you throw the water all the time, The grass, the wine you see growing something like crabgrass, the only thing is bigger, just like straw, like chef and needle, but it's not, but it's a wine, it's a grass.
Okay.
So you pull that, pull up some of that and wash it, and you get some chef and needle and boil it with that. And you're going to be better tonight than you was this morning.
Right.
Okay, now how are we doing? Everything going, yeah?
Everything's straight.
Okay.
Yeah.
In our country, everybody trying to get into getting licensed to plant some herb and grow herb, right? This is one of the herbs of the field. If you look from Bible chat, this is one of the herbs of the field. Cerasee, Bajorina, they are herbs of the field. They all go to see the little medicine, cup that the little herb cup that we buy in the kitchen.
Mm-hmm.
This is one of them. This should be one of them. Okay, let me give you my input on it, but the doctors ain't gonna like. People who does drugs and have a cold, probably bronchitis. Because I've been seeing some people carrying on their head bad, their chest cold and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
But this same Cerasee, they get all hype up because they go to buy their drugs and they have their problem with this and the problem with that.
Mm-hmm.
All they need to do is come home and get some of this Cerasee with go around the yard. Let it dry, or if it dry itself on the wine, it's better you take the leaves and you roll it and smoke it. I'm talking for the smokers now, the people who like to smoke drugs and things. That's the key. That's the key. The problem. They only go to herb marijuana. They only go because that's what they can sell.
Mm-hmm.
Anybody sell us their receipt, they wouldn't go there.
Right.
But this is more healthy than that, because I can trust me.
I have a grand aunt. My great grand aunt.
Mm-hmm.
She's deceased now. Antetta.
Uh-huh.
Not Antetta, sorry, wrong name.
Antetta's not my Antetta. Yeah, well.
You know, Antetta was the name for all the
sisters. Yeah, all the sisters. All
yeah.
The older sisters
yeah.
Are Titta. And the older brothers is Bubba.
Right.
Okay? Okay, let me finish this part.
Go on, yeah.
You roll this up and smoke it, and it's going to calm your mind. It's going to calm your mind so you can go and relax yourself and you ain't got to worry about yourself. Cause you
mm-hmm.
go in the yard, they go in the yard. Everybody
mm-hmm.
smoke some and relax their mind. We can communicate with each other better if we just go to the simpler things of life that we have and
yep.
take it for granted.
That's right. That's right.
Just to add it, so you basically what you're saying is this plant is related to the marijuana plant.
Yes.
The only difference is, and I do know that, the only difference is It doesn't have that high quality of THC.
That's what
exactly.
The killer drug.
Right.
That's the one addictive drug. That's what makes it addictive.
Right. So yeah, that's cool. I just wanted
okay.
to.
Okay. Okay. Something else in my mind I want to feed you is oh come on Jesus. I mentioned bronchitis and TB. Okay. At least bronchitis and TB is related. One is a minor, one is major. This is important information I'm giving you. But if you take the wrong impression, it could be illegal. When I was a child, I'm a few months short of 60 right now. So you hear me keep saying when I was a child.
Mm-hmm.
I still feel like I'm 14, but hey.
Okay.
Hey, when I was a child, it was a long years ago. This name I'm gonna say Madeira Bach.
Yes.
But it is known as mahogany now, and it's also endangered species now.
Mm.
One time ago, in the back, almost everybody holds in the bush, you got one three or four Madeira bark to grow. But
mm-hmm.
since the artists of the Bahamas become known into sculpturing, such as carving, wood carving and so forth, they started to use and overuse and they abuse the bushes and all those places around where we used to have a bunch, not replant, but God grow groves of mahogany in the bushes. We used to see these field fellas come in the back of our bushes and sometimes they might hire one or two places to keep it to themselves to go in the back of the bushes and they leave every day with
mm-hmm.
truckloads and truckloads of trunks of this tree. And they, for now, they cause it to be an endangered species. We're not allowed to touch it. And those places where they used to go in the back of our yards in the bush, ain't on there anymore. But let me show you the good, what I bring up this thing for. The bronchitis, or TB, or this could cure, this could prevent the part of you Remember I said in the beginning, prevention, prevention, not cure. If you got prevention, you ain't need no cure. This bush will prevent anybody from coming into the stage of getting bronchitis, TB, or
ammonia?
Or pneumonia. Because it's so bitter. We wasn't using it for the right thing. A lot of us would have been more healthy and still alive. Those that died from TB or chest infection or whatever, or pneumonia.
Or what they call COVID now.
Or what they call COVID now. If we been strength enough for Madeira back, plenty of us ain't catch no COVID. COVID can pass by and bounce off.
That's so bitter. Oh,
man. It can bounce off. Because trust me, this Madeira bar, let me tell you how to do it if you can find some of those getting catch with it.
Some of my grand aunt, Ozella Taylor, and us, she used to make us drink it as tea in the morning.
Yes.
Back in the day.
If only one.
In the 90s, we used to have to drink that.
If only one ounce.
It's so one spoonful,
spoonful or two spoonfuls.
One spoonful of that to put, make a tea.
Listen,
it was really
good. You see those cups? You see those cups that come or the Quaker's old box?
Yeah.
Those cups?
Yeah.
I had to drink one of them every day. You know why? I had some problems in my blood. Like I say again, the same lady who told me this thing, a lot of this knowledge. I had some things that pop on me called cat boils. And they go to the waist part, the part you need the most, you know, imagine you have a boil up under your arm. And a cat boil ain't just come today and go tomorrow.
Oh, okay.
The cat boil is going to come there and swell up, and swell up, and swell up, and swell up until it gets so hard and hot till it can burst. And you got to squeeze the mommy out of it in order for it to start to heal.
Right.
So what causes you to help, what helping you with that is, if you can take a piece of Madeira bark. You go to the mahogany tree, you trim off a piece of the bark, and then you clean the bark. The outside of the bark was to go off. So just the membrane between the outer bark and the trunk of the tree, that's the healthy part. You take it, you strip it up, you put it in a bottle. And in order to cure it, you must put some alcohol and salt. Not rubbing alcohol, I mean rum. So what you do is better. I've proven this myself. When I was a little kid with the cat boil thing, a woman used to make me drink one of those small Quaker's old cup full of Madeira bark, we call it drink, to make sure I get rid of all the dirty parts in my blood, in my system, and clean me out. Then I had a portman raise of high pressure and always want to punch somebody down. The woman say, get the fever, get the... You shove a needle in water glass and drink it, and you'll cool yourself off.
All right.
Okay? And furthermore, with the bronchitis, the tuberculosis thing, and the pneumonia thing, this is very instrumental. I don't care how old you are, how young you are. The younger the child, the better. If you started, if you want to build a strong family, you get your children some of that. I can tell you the way to get it. In a way, you might have to break the law to get the bar. So if somebody want it, they gotta do it themselves.
Yep.
Get the bar, put in a bottle, then you take some warm water, put in a bottle, shake it up and wash that off. Then you take some, take a bit of salt, sprinkle the bottle, the mouth of the bottle, just to cure the bush. And then you pour about half a pint of rum in it, shake it up, leave it for a day, and then the next day you add water to it. And every time after that, you leave it for 2 days after you add the first set of water. And it's gonna come its right color, red. And then you start drinking. Every time you drink an ounce of it out of the bottle, you pour an ounce of water back. And if it's properly cured, that bottle will never end until you see it, until you can pour in water and the water come out white, then you know, if the water come out clear, then you know it's over.
Okay.
But that's gonna last you a long time.
All right.
So. Okay, I hope I've been helpful. All
right. All right, you ready?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, let's bring you ready. All right, guys, so welcome back to the channel. Yes, everything my father shared, also known as AKA Bushman, Leofus Johnson. back here, it's back to me now, Mr. Forges. So we're gonna close out in a minute. I just want to point out one or two things. All right, so here, right here, we have three different types of
Mashmi Pecan
croton. All right, each one of these, there's a reason why they call them mashmi. As you can clearly see, they have different colors, so you can't match one leaf to the other, no. Right? But one of the things all three of these are excellent for is tea, good tea. Mm-hmm. All right, it's excellent for tea. And the tea, like I said, it's a soothing, more of a soothing tea. You know, you drink it at night, or you can drink it in the morning. If let's say you want to kickstart the old digestive system, you can drink this in the morning. My grandmother used to make this for her every morning and every night before she went to bed. So there's a whole family of croton. These are just three that I picked. But there's something special about this last one. These are the broadleaf croton, all right? These are also mashmi if you can, as you can clearly see. Mm-hmm. You can't, all of them, you can't,
no, come you can't
match them all.
All,
because they all have different marks in different spots. But with this leaf here, one of the things, I remember clearly as a child, my grandmother, I think I sprained my ankle and I was swollen. Mm. Or I think I got bit from something and it's swollen. Mm. I can't remember. But this is also good for bee stings, war stings, ants, if you get bite from ants. That's the most green plants, right? But this particular one, it's good for swelling. It brings down the swelling and it pulls out all of the, let's say, impurities or whatever venom, for the most part, from bugs, right? So how you would prepare this, you would take the same broad piece, and look for a nice broad leaf. You want to get some Buckley's or some ointment mix, right? And you want to rub that on there, and you want to slowly heat this over the stove or over some light. You just want a light heat. You don't want it heavy. Yeah, and the minute you heat it, you want to take it and you want to wrap it around that area, tightly around that area, or you have to get some help and wrap it around, and then tie it up with a nice
cloth
or bandage. And in a few hours, as you rest, whether you want to do it before you go to sleep, or you want to do it while you're just sitting up watching TV or whatever the case is, what you would see happen is the swelling would go down. Mm-hmm. All right? The swelling would go down. Whatever venom was in, whatever you got bit from, even if it wasn't a bite, let's say it's just simple inflammation.
Yeah.
Right?
Yes.
It'll actually help the inflammation go down.
Yes.
You put your foot up, if you got swelling in your foot, you just put your foot up, level, wrap it after you heat it, and it'll help bring that down. You see what I'm saying? So that's how this works. That's basically what I wanted to share. Yeah, from Forges Landscaping. Please, guys, don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the channel. We have more videos coming, a lot of great things, big things coming. Like I said, we're all about promoting small farmers, and not just small farmers as far as livestock, but also plants, greens, herbs, as best as we possibly can. Again, this is my father. Yes, known as Bushman
Cleophas Johnson.
Johnson.
Glad to be able to share.
All right. And with that, I'd say shalom.